Welcome to the Angus Report, a news program for cattle producers.
From American Angus Association headquarters in St. Joseph, Missouri, we bring you the week's top headlines, including revisions to USDA's school lunch program.
We share tips for synchronizing females.
We look at the importance of reproductive data and the Maternal Plus program. And Paige Wallace brings us a preview of what to expect at the National Western Stock Show.
This is the Angus Report. Hello and welcome to the new year. I'm Bob Cervera.
And I'm Crystal Albers.
Our top news this week. A well-planned estrus synchronization and AI program can improve herd productivity and profit. Mike Smith of the University of Missouri says producers can increase the probability for long-term breeding success.
A real major advantage of estrus synchronization and AI in regards to pregnancy rates is the opportunity to get a large number of the females, potentially 60% up to maybe two-thirds of your cows pregnant the first day of the breeding season or within the first week of the breeding season. The first question to ask yourself is what the pregnancy rate has been in my heifers or cows over a 60 to 70 day period. If it's 85% or greater, then those animals are probably good candidates for synchronization and AI. There's tremendous benefit, economic benefit, from having your calves born early in the calving season, and synchronization and AI help with that. But what's happening now for the first time are two things. Is we now have technology which allows the person to be able to inseminate their cows on a single day with high pregnancy rates. But we also have a changing market structure which is beginning to reward producers for the quality of their calves or the genetic improvement of their calves.
The U.S. Department of Agriculture has announced revised school lunch requirements that allow more meats and grains on lunch trays across the country. Facing mounting pressure from lawmakers and others, the agency has temporarily removed the limitations on the amount of grains and meats in the school lunch program through the end of the current 2012-2013 school year. Overall calorie limits for school lunches will remain. USDA cites operational challenges related to implementation and says it will evaluate the guidelines based on feedback and data to determine whether other adjustments are needed.
The Environmental Protection Agency's Lisa Jackson will leave her post as agency administrator this month. Jackson announced she will step down after 4 years at the EPA, where she oversaw some of the most extensive air pollution regulations in the agency's history. Jackson was often criticized for what many in the agriculture community considered overreaching policies pertaining to such issues as dust pollution, water regulations, and EPA surveillance of feeding operations. President Obama has not yet named Jackson's replacement.
Next week, Denver will overflow with cattlemen attending the National Western Stock Show. But the event takes on a global focus Tuesday, January 15th, during the International Livestock Congress. Attendees will hear from top-notch speakers addressing everything from international trade to trends in global beef demand.
Anybody that is involved in producing food from beef cattle, all the way from the rancher to the seed stock to the feedlot to the packer to the retail, the entire food chain should be interested in this program. And also anybody that's doing trade internationally. We select 12 students, graduate and undergraduate students from around the world, to attend the International Livestock Congress. This is a very competitive process, and these students come from all the way from Australia, from Japan, from Canada, from the U.S., to attend the Congress and interact with the industry in the local areas. We'll have an opportunity to go to the show and interact with the members of the International Committee at the Stock Show.
The International Livestock Congress is January 15th at the Renaissance Denver Hotel in Denver, Colorado. Visit nationalwestern.com/international to learn more or to register.
Certified Angus Beef's Education and Culinary Center in Wooster, Ohio, often hosts chefs and academia from throughout the country to exchange ideas and facilitate product development. During a recent panel, attendees discussed some top food trends to watch this year.
We think it's going to be the year of the strip steak on the menus. Lots of different other trends coming out, such as thinking globally but locally, if that makes any sense. What it really means is using local ingredients and infusing that those local ingredients with different flavor profiles from all over the world. Well, Certified Angus Beef believes that there are opportunities for chefs to make a little bit of money and to put a high quality product on the plate.
When the Angus Report returns, Paige Wallace reports on building beef demand through industry collaboration.
And Tom Field of the University of Nebraska explains why failure can be a good thing.
Visit angus.org to continue watching this episode of the Angus Report.